next and the last keynote speaker this morning, he's quite familiar to us because he has been involved with the conference for the past few years. He is the Deputy Director of Thailand Cyber University Project under the Office of Higher Education Commission, Ministry of Education, Thailand, and he is also Vice Dean in Educational Innovation Affairs, Faculty of Pharmaceutical Science, Chulalongkorn University. He's got his PhD in Educational Communications and Technology with the background of Master of Science in Computer Science. He's involved in many TCU projects, and he was also one of the teaching team who taught the first MOOCs in Thailand, e-learning professional certificate program, the first MOOC style course opened on August 2010. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, may I present Dr. Anuchai Theeraroungchaisri.
Good afternoon, everyone. it's my great pleasure to become here to present briefly the update of Thai MOOC by Thailand Cyber University, and also a great pleasure because this is the last presenter at the lunch time. You hear a lot of content on knowledge, and maybe you are very tired and very hungry also. So I promise to present very short and brief about the update of Thai MOOC. Okay, let's start from the topic that I would like to present. I will present in four short topics. First, please allow me to review the background or history of the Thai MOOC, and then the outcome of the first phase of Thai MOOC. And then the national policy, 20-year, we call the 20-year national strategy of Thailand. Very new and very update, very, very interesting. And then the update, the new vision of the Thai MOOC. Okay, many of you may know that from 2015, our government have launched a new policy called Thailand Digital Economy. At that policy, they're aiming to create the digital society, digital economy platform framework that will raise the nation to have a more income nation. And one of the pillars is the digital society. And one of the strategy is to encourage, to support the lifelong learning of all people in Thailand. Back to the Thailand Cyber University Project. Under the Office of Higher Education Commission, Ministry of Education, the project was founded in 2005. We did a lot of project on online education, starting from the open courseware portal in 2005. We opened the portal for university to share their open courseware, and success very much, and a lot of people, faculty member and student utilize our portal. And then we start to open e-learning professional certificate to educate, to training the faculty member, the teacher who want to do the online education. This is a MOOC style certificate program that we launched. At that time, we did not know that this is a MOOC style course before. Then we launched a project called TCU Globe Project that interconnect all open courseware portal in Thailand for some university portal and to the international many regions, and very successful too. And now we plan to launch the MOOC project. But at the same time that the government run the digital economy policy, so we combine with, partner with the three ministry, three organizations. we submit a proposal to establish the Thai MOOC. You can see that three major ministries, Ministry of Science and Technology, Ministry of Education, and Ministry of Digital Economy and Society. At that time, the name is the Ministry of ICT, but now become Ministry of Digital Economy and Society. our vision is to establish Thai MOOC as a lifelong learning space for all Thai. This is our vision and imagine that if we have a portal of a MOOC course that can support every person from children until their retirement age. So it will support the lifelong learning of all people. We have to create the MOOC course portal. We have to create the learning portfolio system, and also the very important is the credit bank system that collect the credit that the learner have passed. We separate duty among ministry. Ministry of Digital Economy take care of the infrastructure, the computer, the technology things. Ministry of Science and Technology by BITEC take care of the software and platform, customize software, modify and create new software. And then for TCU, under the Office of Higher Education, we develop the content with the support of the university. Outcome of the first phase, we got three major important outcomes. The first is we got the Thai MOOC platform that provide the Thai MOOC course to all learners. We adopt and customize from OpenEdX software. And then we got the standard and guideline for MOOC course development. This is the foundation. This is the guideline that we use for anyone who want to develop the MOOC course and to open and deliver via the Thai MOOC platform. And at last, we have 195 MOOC course developed from the university throughout the Thailand. This is our system, our platform. You can see from the bottom side, this is the MOOC LMS that we adopt from EdX, and then we also integrating to the testing and credit bank that we looking forward that the learner from the MOOC course can go to testing in the test center, and then if they pass, their record of success will record in the test bank. So it's a strategy to encourage them to go further higher education. The learning journey similar like this. The student who learn as their own interest, they stop after pass the course and get the certificate. But the one that who want to collect their credit, learning credit, they have to go to the testing center. And then if they pass, their record will keep collect in the credit bank. And if the home university of the student allow, the credit will transfer to the home university. And if they collect as many credit, they can transfer to certificate or degree. Okay. And in the underlying, you can see that there are many things that we have to done. For example, the infrastructure, the quality assurance system, the guideline, the administration system, and also the supporting system. This is the MOOC course, MOOC website. This is the standard and guideline. We developed the guideline with the support from the faculty member, the researcher from university. The guideline have the process along the MOOC course development. So emphasize on the quality in each step of the process. we got 195 MOOC courses from the 7 regional university networks. Totally, we have 9, but at first phase, 7 university network participate in and join us. The result come out at the statistic from the July 18, 195 MOOC courses open, 70,000 learner register, and 121,000 course registration time. And the most popular is the basic photography course, 4,500 learner. Yeah. And the second one is psychology in daily life. This is the demographic of the age of the learner. If you think back at the yesterday morning, Professor William from the Trudell, you can see that the pattern of the distribution may be similar, but the age of the learner, the medium age of learner in Thailand, maybe in the very popular, very famous course is 31. And you can see that the student in the university is only one third, 31%. And we have a learner that have more than 41 years old, 17%. This similar pattern to other courses. So from this, we learned that maybe now we are ready for online education, and maybe not only the younger, the university ages, but also all people from all age. Maybe the adult learner or the retirement also can learn from this way of education. This is the map. This map shows the location of the learner. You can see that the yellow dot spread throughout Thailand. This is the education of the learner. We have after bachelor and before bachelor degree. Okay, the impact of the first phase come out that in Thailand, from our observation, MOOC get into the mainstream of open education. At least 2 university level MOOC platform was launched from the top 2 university. Theeraroungchaisri University launched ThuraMOOC, and Mahidol University have MUX, and at least maybe more will come in the near future. And the last number of university instructor show interested in in developing MOOC course and providing education via MOOC course. We can see that the application form that submit to get fund from the Thai MOOC second phase, we have increased 100% from the first phase. So many faculty members interested in. And also, there are many national institutes have introduced and used, have strategy to use MOOC as one of their strategy to do staff capacity development. For example, the Office of Civil Service Commission take care of the education of the all Thai civil service. And also Thai Professional Qualification Institute that take care of capacity building for the skilled worker, skilled people, and also the Digital Economy Promotion Agency, and many, many public organizations interested in. Now, MOOC has been widely accepted as an education system for lifelong learning. We can see that at the national level, the 20 years national development strategy that newly launched mentioned about using MOOC as a way to provide lifelong education. This is the 20 year national strategy. They have 6 key strategies. The key strategy number 3 is development and empowerment of human capital. There are many sections and mention about the lifelong education, mention about the transformation of learning, and also MOOC is one of the keywords that was mentioned in the national policy. So this come out the situation after the first phase. Everyone get into the MOOC, utilize MOOCs, not only the university, but also the public organization or involved or participate in the MOOC. How can we take this good opportunity to benefit the future of Thai education? Back to this picture, from the learner side, what is the thing that motivates them? They want to get knowledge, they want to advance in their career, they want to get more higher degree. This is the motivation. But also, they need something not complex, not sophisticated. They need one-stop platform or unified platform. They just learn to use this platform only once and they can learn everything. They want their portfolio of learning to be consolidated into one portfolio, not separate into different and many platform. They want to collective their learning credit, and then they can use their learning credit into everything that they want to further their education or to advance their career, something like this. Back to the provider, the MOOC course provider. There are many universities that want to provide MOOC course, and also they have their own target, their own learner that they want to provide to them. But they also, many MOOC course provider, TPQI, OCSC, the civil service, all they have their own target, but their target are overlap. Or maybe many one of us had more than one head. Sometimes we are civil service, sometimes we are engineer, something like this. So it is a good way that we can combine all courses from all provider into one place and provide it a simple way to the learner, and all provider can utilize, provide the course to all people in all ages as their target. So benefit both the provider and benefit both the learner. So as a government organization that initiated the Thai MOOC, so we have to concern about, we have to focus more on the developing of the platform. So if we have a national MOOC platform that all major MOOC provider want to provide the MOOC course via this platform, you can see that the benefit will benefit to all learner and all provider. The investment will be more efficient. The quality of education will be improved. If we can consolidate, coordinate, we can do a research, we can combine our research together and make a good guideline for MOOC course development, the learner will get a good consolidation of the learning portfolio. And with the strong and reliable of the infrastructure and also the security system, we can provide a trust and confident learning outcome, learning result from the learner. So at the first phase of Thai MOOC, we emphasize on establish the system, try to provide the MOOC courses, support the university. We as the project, we did not create the MOOC courses by ourselves, but with the support from the university, network. Together we can build a lot of MOOC courses. But in the second phase, now MOOC will become the mainstream. So we have to focus more on building the strong, reliable, and fast infrastructure. We have to focus more on the quality assurance system and develop a good guideline to encourage, to facilitate all faculty or institution that want to create and provide a MOOC course. We have to create a security and very efficiency credit bank system that will be the central recording of the credit, and then will be shared among all institutions that would like to utilize the learning credit of the learner. So we have to set the standard. And then we can be the training, supporting service, and continually research to improve the quality and do a knowledge management as a yearly conference as this one. And also, as a central body, maybe we can facilitate the coordination with other international MOOC or national MOOC and MOOC provider, so maybe the central portion. Okay, that's the thing I would like to update everyone, and that's the time for lunch also. Thank you very much.